Crossy Road. It was once massively popular and played by millions of people. The original game has a top-down view, but in this video, I'll try to recreate Crossy Road, but in first person. Now, if you're unaware of Crossy Road, then you're living under a rock. It has very similar gameplay to Frogger. If you don't know Frogger, are you a caveman? The goal in Crossy Road is to try and go as far as you can without getting hit by obstacles, such as cars. This is a simple mechanic, yet it is highly addictive. I figured perhaps making the game first person will give the player more suspense, because, you know, more suspense equals more fun. Why else would anyone ride roller coasters? Anyways, aside from that, I've given myself a challenge. I tried to make the game without writing a single line of code. At this point, you might say, "Oh, I've seen this before. You must be trying out visual scripting, right?" And to that, my answer is no. Instead of visual scripting, I'll be using something called GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot is an AI pair programmer that draws context from comments and code and suggests individual lines and whole functions instantly. What this means is, I write comments, and it write code. So essentially, I'm instructing an AI to write all the code for me. Just in case, I'm not sponsored by GitHub to make this video, but if you're watching this GitHub, I'm always open for possible sponsorships. First off, I had to make a custom player controller. Crossy Road has a unique movement style, in which the player movement takes place on a grid. As soon as I started making a script called player controller, GitHub Copilot magically figured out what I wanted to do and gave me a suggestion to create a speed variable. I then wrote a single line of comment describing how the player controller should take WASD input from the player, and the AI figured out the rest of the code. It's quite impressive, but the player controller is probably one of the easier things that GitHub Copilot can handle. Besides the grid-snapped movement style, Crossy Road's character also jumps every time they move. I first thought this could be done quite easily just by using camera animations instead of actually moving the character up and down. However, I quickly realized this could potentially be problematic if I want to expand the player controller to do things such as ground detection. Instead, this was my plan. Say if a player presses a W key to move forward. This will calculate 3 points: starting position, end position, and a point in the middle with a y-axis value of jump power, so like 1. From here, all I need to do is make the player smoothly go through these 3 points. But here's a small problem. When linearly smoothing a position from one place to another with a constant speed, the player would move something like this. As you can tell, it's not impactful, making it boring. To solve this problem, we can use something called easing functions. They are used to specify the rate of change of a variable. In my case, I'll be using this easing function to describe the acceleration of the velocity. So in the end, it looks something like this. This may look a bit odd from this animation, but when this concept is actually applied to the game, and with some minor camera animations, it looks quite pleasing. This was all done by using an asset called LeanTween. It was a perfect asset for me to make this type of movement system, as it supported easing functions out of the box. By the way, GitHub Copilot was smart enough and wrote all the LeanTween specific code for me. Once I was somewhat happy with the player controller, I began making 3D voxel style models. I made some trees, various cars, and a train. I then went on to actually making them alive in the game. There were some minor difficulties, but I got it working quickly after. Aside from that, I also added a death effect. Basically, I just enabled a rigid body component of the player whenever the player collides with a car. At this point, I had implemented the majority of the features I wanted to have in the game, except one thing: terrain generation. The game is supposed to be an endless runner game, so the map had to be generated real time. I actually took one of the easier approaches to make this possible. I made a bunch of pre-made chunks of a map, so basically, I can put them randomly together in real time. This isn't the best solution to make creative maps, but at least I can avoid problems with unplayable generated maps. And this is easier for me to make. While I was making the terrain generation system, I was genuinely really impressed by how well GitHub Copilot worked. I was able to get a rough first version within just 5 minutes of writing comments and accepting the code suggestions. There was another issue with the map. There were too many cars in the scene that were constantly being destroyed and created, lowering the performance. If only I could reuse the cars. Oh wait, I can! There is a concept of design pattern called object pool, and here's how it works. Let's say there is something called a pool in which all the objects are stored. These objects are initialized when the game first starts, so they are ready to use. Whenever something requests for an object, it should take out an object from this pool. And then, when the object is no longer needed, it is safely put in the pool again. Now, this works very well if we have multiple objects of the same kind. In my case, I've implemented this system not only for the cars, but also for the terrain chunks. I then polished the game by making a simple main menu, death screen UI, and adding some sound effects. And that finishes my version of Crossy Road in first-person view. In case you want to play the game on your own, I have a link to my itch.io page in the description. Regarding the GitHub Copilot, I'm honestly blown away by how well it worked. It gave me accurate code suggestions within seconds that I could actually use. Sometimes my brain wasn't even fast enough to catch up with several of the suggestions it gave. With that being said, it wasn't perfect either. Sometimes it would suggest a code with a different function name unless I specifically named the function correctly. While you may be able to get around with writing a single line of comment to make simpler things, such as player controllers, anything that's more specific to your project may require you to write more lines of comments. Now, to answer the question if you can completely make a game in Unity without having any programming experiences and absolutely relying on GitHub Copilot, I don't think you can. You see, programming isn't just about knowing different syntaxes. You need to have problem-solving skills, and you should know how you should approach a problem in order to solve it. If you have prior programming experiences but just don't know Unity C# syntaxes, I think GitHub Copilot can be a good assistant for your next project. Last thing before I go, I was originally going to upload a Project Terminal devlog this time, because, you know, I upload Project Terminal devlog every other video, but I couldn't get enough things done this time. I actually completely redesigned the map, polished some visual stuff, and I also wanted to work on some other mechanics. I wanted to showcase all of that in just one video. I guess I managed my time incorrectly. Or maybe I just got demotivated in working on a project after a week long of hardcore game dev from Game Jam I joined, so I couldn't get any work done for a week. Regardless, I decided to make a shorter, easier to make video, and here it is. It's also why it took an extra week, because I changed my upload schedule in the middle. Or maybe I should have just kept working on the Project Terminal and released the Project Terminal devlog instead of this Crossy Road remake video when I was gonna spend the same one extra week. This has been Semicoder. I kind of know how to code.